110, lab number one, talk about factoring and review that from Math 100. So the rules of factoring that you want to keep in mind is, first, make sure that the polynomial that you're trying to factor is in descending order. That means starting with highest power of x and going down. So that would be like x squared plus 3x minus 1. That would be descending order. The second thing you want to look for after you put the polynomial in descending order is look for a greatest common factor. Not every problem will have a greatest common factor, but always makes it easier if you can find that and pull it out first. So after you've done the greatest common factor, then we look at counting the number of terms in the polynomial. If there are four terms, we're going to try to use the strategy of grouping. If there are three terms, we're going to use the X method. This is the most common method that we will use and what we will use most today. And if there are two terms, you look for a difference of squares, which would indicate a square on the variable usually, or a sum or difference of cubes, and that would be indicated with a third power on the variable for that to be the case. So let's look at some examples of this and try to review factoring a little bit. So we'll start with this polynomial here. It is in descending order. We have x squared plus 2x minus 8. That is descending order. So then we look for a greatest common factor. X squared and 2x and negative 8 don't have anything in common other than 1. So there's no GCF to pull out. So we're going to use the X method to factor this. So there's a 1 in front of x squared. So you take the leading coefficient times the constant on the end. So 1 times negative 8 is negative 8. And then the 2, the middle number, goes in the bottom. We need numbers that multiply to be negative 8 and add to be positive 2. So that would be 4 times negative 2. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. 4 plus negative 2 is positive 2. Since there is a 1 in front of x squared, that will allow us to go straight to our factors. Since that's a positive 4, the factor will be x plus 4. That's a negative 2. That's going to be a minus x minus 2. And that is the factored form for that polynomial using the X method. Let's look at another example. Another trinomial, three terms. It is in descending order already. 6x squared plus 11x plus 4. We look for a greatest common factor. 6 and 4 have something in common, but the 11 doesn't have anything in common with those. So there's no GCF. So we're going to go to X method. We'll take the leading coefficient. 6 times 4 is 24. That's what goes in the top. In the bottom is the middle number, the 11. So we need the numbers that multiply to be 24 and add to be 11. 6 times 4 multiplies to be 24, but adds to be 10. So that's not it. 12 times 2 adds to be 14. So that's not it. 8 times 3 multiplies to be 24, and 8 plus 3 is 11. So because that doesn't have a 1 in front of it, the x squared, it's got another number. This is where we have to replace the middle term, 8x, 3x plus 4, with those two numbers from the sides of the x. And then we group, as this now has four terms. So first two together, second two together. We look for a greatest common factor of the first two. 6x squared and 8x have a 2x in common, leaving 3x plus 4. 3x plus 4 have a 1 in common. Because it's a positive 3x, it's going to be a positive 1. And that would leave us 3x plus 4 in the parentheses. And the final factored form, you've got the matching parentheses. 3x plus 4 is the first factor. The second factor is the stuff in front of those, 2x plus 1. And there's the factored form for that trinomial. Okay. Look at the next example. This one only has two terms. It is in the right order. We got x squared and then a number, so that is in the right order. But since it has two terms, we're looking for one of those strategies, either difference of squares or sum or difference of cubes. Because this has an x squared, we know it's a difference of, possibly could be a difference of squares. So when we're looking to investigate the difference of squares, we try to rewrite the problem as a subtraction of two square things. So we look, what squared gets me 4, or 2? What squared gets me an x squared? That'd be an x. What squared gets me 9? 3. 2x times 2x is 4x squared. 3 times 3 is 9. That's how I'm getting those numbers. And then because it does work to be able to rewrite it that way, I can do this to get the factors. It's kind of a shortcut. Take 2x plus 3, 2x minus 3. It's always going to be whatever's in the parentheses of the difference of squares. And that's the factored form for that quadratic there with the 4x squared minus 9. So some review over factoring of polynomials.